An isolated, agrarian society until the mid-20th century, Nepal entered the modern era in 1951 without schools, hospitals, roads, telecommunications, electric power, industry, or civil service. The country has, however, made progress towards sustainable economic growth since the 1950s and is committed to a program of economic liberalization. Nepal has used a series of five-year plans in an attempt to make progress in economic development. It completed its ninth economic development plan in 2002, its currency has been made convertible, and 17 state enterprises have been privatized. Foreign aid to Nepal accounts for more than half of the development budget. Government priorities over the years have been the development of transportation and communication facilities, agriculture, and industry. Since 1975, improved government administration and rural development efforts have been emphasized. Agriculture remains Nepal's principal economic activity, employing 70% of the population and providing 37% of GDP. Only about 20% of the total area is cultivable, another 33% is forested, most of the rest is mountainous. Rice and wheat are the main food crops. The lowland Terai region produces an agricultural surplus, part of which supplies the food-deficient hill areas. GDP is heavily dependent on remittances of foreign workers. Subsequently, economic development in social services and infrastructure in Nepal has not made dramatic progress. A countrywide primary education system is under development, and Tribhuvan University has several campuses. Please see Education in Nepal for further details. Although eradication efforts continue, malaria had been controlled in the fertile but previously uninhabitable Terai region in the south. Kathmandu is linked to India and nearby hill regions by road and an expanding highway network. The capital was almost out of fuel and transport of supplies caused by a crippling general strike in southern Nepal on February 17, 2008. Major towns are connected to the capital by telephone and domestic air services. The export-oriented carpet and garment industries have grown rapidly in recent years and together now account for approximately 70% of merchandise exports. The cost of living index in Nepal is comparatively lower than many countries but not the least. The quality of life has declined to much less desirous value in recent years. Nepal was ranked 54th worst of 81 ranked countries on the Global Hunger Index in 2011, between Cambodia and Togo. Nepal's current score of 19.9 is better than in 2010 and much improved than its score of 27.5 in 1990. Foreign investments and taxation. Huge numbers of small foreign investments come to Nepal via the non-resident Nepali, who are investing in shopping mall, plaza, real estate business, tourism, etc. Nepal has huge capacity of hydroelectricity due to which huge number of foreign companies are in line, but the political instability has stopped the process at the same time it's growing on its own. Nepal entered into agreement for avoidance of double taxation with 10 countries since 1987. Similarly, it has investment protection agreement with 5 countries since 1983. In 2014, Nepal restricted the foreign aid by setting minimum limit for foreign grants, soft and commercial loans from its development partners. Imports and exports. Nepal's merchandise trade balance has improved somewhat since 2000 with the growth of the carpet and garment industries. In the fiscal year 2000-2001, exports posted a greater increase than imports, helping bring the trade deficit down by 4% from the previous year to $749 million. Recently, the European Union has become the largest buyer of ready-made garments from Nepal. Exports to the EU accounted for 46.13% of the country's garment exports. The annual monsoon rain, or lack of it, strongly influences economic growth. From 1996 to 1999, real GDP growth averaged less than 4%. The growth rate recovered in 1999, rising to 6%, before slipping slightly in 2001 to 5.5%. Strong export performance, including earnings from tourism and external aid, have helped improve the overall balance of payments and increase international reserves. Several multilateral organizations such as the World Bank, the Asian Development Bank, and the UN Development Programme also provide assistance. In June 1998, Nepal submitted its Memorandum on a Foreign Trade Regime to the World Trade Organization and in May 2000 began direct negotiations on its accession. Macroeconomic trend. This is a chart of trend of gross domestic products of Nepal at market prices estimated by the International Monetary Fund and Econstats with figures in millions of Nepalese rupees. Statistics. GDP. Purchasing power parity $42.60 billion GDP. Real growth rate. 5.00% GDP per capita. Purchasing power parity $1,400 GDP. Composition by sector. Agriculture. 33% industry. 17% services. 50% population below poverty line. 23.8% household income or consumption by percentage share. Lowest 10%. 3.2%. Highest 10%. 29.8% inflation rate, 8.0% labor force, 10 million note, severe lack of skilled labor. Labor force by occupation, agriculture 81%, services 16%, industry 3%, unemployment rate, 38%. Budget, revenues, $665 million. Expenditures, $1.1 billion, including capital expenditures of $NR industries, tourism, carpet, textile, small rice, jute, sugar, and oilseed mills, cigarette, cement and brick production. Industrial production growth rate, 8.7%. Electricity production, 1,755 gigawatt-hours. Electricity production by source, fossil fuel, 8.5%. hydro, 91.5%. nuclear, 0%. other, 0%. Electricity consumption, 1,764 gigawatt hours. Electricity exports, 95 gigawatt hours. Electricity imports, 227 gigawatt hours. Oil production, 0 barrels per day. Oil consumption, 16,000 barrels per day. 2001. Agriculture products, rice, maize, wheat, sugarcane, root crops, milk. Domestic buffalo meat exports, $568 million FOB, but does not include unrecorded border trade with India. Exports, commodities, carpets, clothing, leather goods, jute goods, grain. Exports, partners, India 50.5%, US 26%, Germany 6.6%. imports, $1.419 billion FOB, imports, commodities, gold, machinery and equipment, petroleum products, fertilizer. Imports, partners, India 82.9%, China 13.5%, UAE 2.6%, Singapore 2.1%, Saudi Arabia 1.2%. Debt. External, $2.7 billion. Economic aid, recipient, $424 million. Currency, 1 Nepalese rupee equals 100 pesa. Fiscal year,